to do the reverse illusions out of a pencil turn. Reminding you of a pencil turn, the thighs are nice and tight, the foot is about 1 inch off the floor. You finish that double pencil turn and you're here at your corner. Your standing legs turned out, it's gonna go through first position. As your body starts to go down into the illusion, you're gonna lift up on belly, the leg continues to go as the head goes down. It comes straight back up and finishes nice and parallel to the floor.
If you do a search for dance tutorials on YouTube, you will find countless tutorials with millions of views, indicating that these are extremely popular with the viewing public. In fact, if we look at the slick back tutorial with 16 million views, we shall see that it has 484,000 likes, and even a comment that says, "Not gonna lie, after practicing for a few days, I learnt it." Now, the popularity of online dance tutorials has also been picked up upon in this 2020 book titled Perpetual Motion. The author Harmony Bench contrasts the popularity of online dance tutorials supplanting that of learning dance live within a community. In fact, she goes on to highlight karenxcheng, a self-proclaimed online dance learner, who shows her time-lapse video as evidence of the success of online dance tutorials through her precise, distinct, and confident movements. But is everyone an autodidact like Karen? Will every dance learner gain the same level of success and find online dance learning effective? For the purposes of this critique, we will be limiting our scope to dance tutorial videos under 4 minutes, and the content of the video focusing only on a specific move like a handstand, a turn, or a split. Now, the first few assumptions that the majority of dance learners make, in no particular order, are the credibility or authority of the online dance tutorial instructor, and the popularity of the video as evidenced by the view count and likes, which they equate to the majority's approval of the reputability, effectiveness, and success of the video's quality of instruction. For example, in the opening introduction of this video, the demonstrating dancer is clearly able to perform the move with a high degree of proficiency. If they can do it credibly, they should be able to teach it effectively, right? And if we look at the video, it has 134,000 views and 1,500 likes. Furthermore, the online dance instructor has 327,000 subscribers and 295 videos produced. Surely, 327,000 people can't be wrong in following this online dance instructor's content. The next set of assumptions that the dance learners make are the simplicity and conciseness of the video's instructions equating to effectiveness and therefore learning the move quickly and simply, the convenience and flexibility of an own-time, own-target approach to learning the move being an appeal and therefore attractive and effective feature of the online dance tutorial video, and the success rate as attested by commenters and other dance learners posting their successes, such as karenxcheng mentioned earlier. Remember earlier on, when we looked at the slick back tutorial video, a commenter attested their success in learning the move in a few days. In fact, when dance learners see credible online dance instructors producing short instructional videos, then surely learning the moves must be as simple and concise as the few steps that the credible and professional instructors have distilled for the dance learning audience, right? And dance learners can take their dance learning anywhere. Surely, success, right? Well, at least looking like a fool is better than crashing around in our living room. At this point, one might raise the argument that aren't these online dance tutorials valid to some extent? If they were really all charlatans, then how are they themselves able to learn the move and execute them in the first place? Well, yes, there is validity to a certain extent. Firstly, we do acknowledge that the online dance instructors have successfully learned the move themselves and are able to execute the move. But just because somebody can do something does not mean that they have the ability to teach it effectively to all sorts of dance learners. Secondly, while the steps themselves are valid in the progression of learning the particular dance move, they may not consist of all the steps, either in the sequence of learning the dance move or in supplementarily aiding in troubleshooting certain aspects of honing the dance move. This includes prerequisite steps before embarking on a move, intermediate steps to bridge between steps, and cross-training in the form of developing strength or a secondary coordination that might aid in the move itself. If we refer back to the lady who crashed learning the reverse illusion dance move, her prerequisite would be to work on her flexibility in a split. Her intermediate step would be to practice rotating in a circle in a 6 o'clock split position using her hands. And her cross-supplementary training would be to strengthen her standing leg strength in sustaining, pivoting on one leg with good balance and control. In fact, our previously cited author Harmony Bench goes on to criticize the basic mimicry of online dance learning is just presumptuous and reductive. So then, what constitutes effective dance teaching? One of the fundamentally acknowledged point of view is that learners are unique individuals, and this would apply to dance learners as well. In this dance research journal, the author Sandra Minton states that dance learners all have different body types, which would affect the execution of any dance move. She also states that dance learners have different kinesthetic and spatial intelligences, and that these factors all have to be considered in the process of effective dance learning and teaching. Clearly, short-form online dance tutorials omit this aspect of considering the dance learner as a unique individual with different body types, be it in terms of strength, flexibility or limb length, as well as disregarding different kinesthetic intelligences such as coordinative ability and proprioception. Secondly, formative feedback is acknowledged as fundamental to any effective learning pedagogy. Feedback from dance teacher to dance learner is integral in effective dance teaching and learning, not just in terms of achieving the execution of a move, but in a safe manner towards taking precautions to injuries. Furthermore, a dance teacher can give a wide variety of cues and prompts, and these are dependent on the teacher observing the dance learner live and in person. This can lead to the teacher guiding the student with cross-training, which, as mentioned previously, may take the form of exercises or activities that supplementarily aid with the particular dance move, or altering the progressive steps towards the dance move to prevent injury and increase precision, which is in essence introducing more intermediary steps based on formative feedback. Finally, within formative feedback comes formative assessment before embarking on learning any dance move. This involves the dance teacher assessing the dance learner's ability and therefore suitability to learning any specific dance move. Again, we can clearly see that online dance tutorials are clearly handicapped in their formative feedback engagement with the dance learner, and therefore, online dance tutorials cannot possibly progress towards effective dance teaching. Lastly, a positive learning environment is crucial to effective dance teaching and learning. A physically safe environment is necessary, and the effective dance teacher will consider the location and if aiding or safety equipment is required, such as a ballet bar or a dance mat. Aside from the physical environment, an effective dance teacher would also strive to create a positive learning environment through fostering a sense of community amongst fellow dance learners. In fact, regardless of how skilled a dance learner is, they will be disadvantaged if placed in an unfavorable environment, and undoubtedly, mishaps may occur. So now that we know what effective dance teaching and learning involves, let us summarize the main points of our argument against the assumptions of online dance tutorials. While we acknowledge the credibility in terms of execution of the dance move from the online dance instructors, and that this brings popular approval from the masses, we affirm that execution alone does not equate effective teaching, and that effective teaching is contingent upon recognizing the dance learner's individual abilities and giving formative feedback and assessment on their learning progress, which online dance tutorials are incapable of engaging in. Likewise, we dismantle the notion of simplicity of progressive steps as equating to effective learning or teaching, as we have addressed that formative feedback is necessary in modifying or altering those steps to suit the dance learner in terms of addressing prerequisites, intermediary steps, and supplementary training. Next, we have shown that convenience and flexibility of time and space actually are detrimental to creating a positive dance learning environment which is safe and conducive for effective dance learning to take place. Lastly, the success point is an argument from absentia or silence. There could be an even larger majority of dance learners who refrain from commenting or filming themselves for fear of embarrassment from admitting that they were or are still unable to learn the particular dance move. Even with regards to the positive example of karenxcheng, further research into her history reveals that she has had experiences with live dance learning, despite her self-proclaimed advocacy of being a solely online dance learner. So I hope you have seen why online dance tutorials cannot be effective dance teaching methods alone. Now, if you have any further questions or queries, do post them in the comments below, and I will see you in the next video.